Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
So God got you guys in this situation for a rebuke for you to come out of it. Because a wise man, give me that Ecclesiastes 7:7. Because
bring it out.
This is the form of God rebuke. God is saying, you know what? Y'all don't want to listen to me? Here, listen to your enemy. Okay? But what a wise man gonna do when he in his captivity, when he in his estate for him and his people? Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and verse 7.
Come on. Bring it out.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man.
You know what God said, black and Hispanic man? Surely this form of estate should make you mad. Only if you wise though. If you foolish, you okay with it. If you foolish, you okay with your woman ruling over you. Your kids not listening to you. You from woman to woman, different households. You got a baby mama over here, a baby mama over there. You sisters got a baby daddy here, a baby daddy there. Read.
And a gift destroyeth the heart.
What does a gift do?
Destroyeth the heart.
Section 8 have destroyed the hearts of our black women. Yeah. Have destroyed the hearts of our black men. Food stamps have destroyed us. We think that what? We are all one now because we get these little gifts.
This is the book of Judith, chapter 5 and verse 17.
Bring it out.
And well as they sin, not before their God, they prosper.
You hear what the Bible is telling you, black and Hispanic men? Read it again.
And well as they sin, not.
If they what?
And well as they sin, not.
If they what?
And well as they sin, not.
If you sin, not. Sin is a transgression of the laws of God.
That's right.
And well as they sin, not.
Come on.
Before their God, they prosper.
They did what?
They prosper.
We did what?
They prosper.
If we sin not,
that's
we
right.
Prosper.
That's right.
You think the little education that you got is prosperity over here in the land of your captivities?
Right.
Huh? You think you got your master's degree? That's a form of prosperity? That is nothing in compared to what God got in store for you if you were to listen to him. If you were to come back to his commandments, black and Hispanic man. Read.
Because the God that hateth iniquity.
The God do what?
Because the God that hateth iniquity.
This is not the Bible. God said he hates sin. Read.
But when they departed from the way which he appointed unto them.
When we departed from the way that God have appointed to us. How do we depart from that way? Woman got on pants. Okay, that's a form of departing from the ways of God. Man not keeping the Sabbath day. Man don't got their households in order. Smoking squares, selling squares, selling drugs to your people. Okay, those are ways what?
But when they departed from the way which he appointed them.
We departed from the ways that God appointed to us. That's why we in this lower state right now. Y'all, I hope y'all understand what God is trying to convey to you. This is out of the Bible. This is not our own vain opinion. God wrote this through holy man. Read.
That's right.
They were destroyed in many battles, very sore.
We are destroyed. We are so destroyed right now today that we become so low that we sell dope to our own brothers.
Right.
We whore out our sisters.
Right.
Okay, and it's become the norm to us today. We don't, normal people don't live like that. What the hell is wrong with y'all? Wake up, read.
And we're led captives.
And we're led what?
And we're led captives.
God have led us captives. Let the so-called white man, the Arab man, and the African man to come together and take us captive in the 1619 transatlantic slave trade. Read.
And we're led captives
come on.
Into a land that was not theirs.
This land, newsflash, black. black man. Newsflash, black woman, this land ain't yours.
That's
although
right.
You comfortable here, God put you here for your what? This was a form of God's rebuke for you to repent. Read it again.
But, excuse me, and were led captives into a land that was not theirs.
Come on.
And the temple of their God was cast to the ground.
Come on.
And their cities were taken by the enemies.
And our cities have been taken by the enemies. Our original city, which was Jerusalem,
right,
have been taken and trotted down by the Gentiles. When you read Ezekiel, the 35th chapter.
That's right.
Read. Jump to verse 20.
Verse 20. Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people.
So there was an Ammonite guy, just a Japanese man, giving an Edomite or a white man the history on us. Showing you guys that these nations today know our history. They know we are the true biblical Jews. Okay? He just gave a whole rundown on who he was because he was asking them, why ain't these people coming down here to worship me, bow to me, submit themselves to me? Read.
Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people.
So he's telling them, if these people in the midst of sin, read.
And they sin against their God.
Come on.
Let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
That's why you being sold to every Saturday, which is the Sabbath day. Okay? They know that sin is all ruin.
Right.
Okay? They know sin is all ruin. That's why they think of all sorts of ways to keep us trapped in the midst of sin.
Right.
They know this. Who don't know it? You black and Hispanics. That's right. Why we here to teach it to you today. Read.
And let us go up, and we shall overcome them.
That's how come we've been overcame as a people. We are overcame as a people. How? Because we are at the lowest estate. We are anywhere you go. When blacks move in, what the other nations do? They move out. The property value drop. We are undesired.
Verse 20. Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
So they know if we in the midst of sin, they can keep us at a lower state at all given times. But read on. What's the flip side to that? Black and Hispanic man, read.
Verse 21.
Come on.
But if there be no iniquity in their nation.
If there be no sin in our nation. If there be no abortions in our nation. If there be no idolatry in our nation. Read.
Let my Lord now pass by.
Let who?
Let my Lord now pass by.
He's telling them, keep it moving. If they ain't in the midst of sin, you better keep it moving. Why?
Lest their Lord defend them.
That's who?
Lest their Lord defend them.
Lest the black Messiah, Jesus the Christ, defend us.
That's
y'all
right.
Understand that? But it's a stipulation. We got to keep the commandments, black man.
Right.
We got to keep the Sabbath day holy, black man.
That's right.
Marriage is honorable in all, black man.
Right.
Okay? Y'all understand these basic laws? Right.
Start with verse 3.
Okay.
1 Peter chapter 4, verse 3.
Read.
For the time past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles. We have walked in lasciviousness.
We have walked in what?
Lasciviousness.
We have walked in what?
Lasciviousness.
Lasciviousness. I know that's not an everyday average Negro word. That means a strong form of sexual desires. Okay? That's what God said. Read.
Lust.
Lust. Read on.
Excess of wine.
Excess of wine. Excess of wine. Excess of wine. That means what? It's okay when the Bible, the prophets drunk liquor in moderation. But when it comes to excess, meaning what? When you become a drunkard, when you drink over your limit, that is when the sin come in. Read.
Reveling.
Revelings. Going from clubbing. In other words, read.
Banqueting.
Come on.
And abominable idolatries.
And abominable idolatries. Guess what? The next mega holiday coming up is an abominable idolatry.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.